Pirak Pirambit. Hold on like you feel.
Wanna play blind man's buff?
Guillaume, what are you doing here?
Leave me be. Without my Vivian, life has no meaning. You are the last to whom I wish to speak.
You'll not find work here. Not paying work.
The guard brings peace to our domains.
Glad to have.
The Tourne is champion.
Up to Gondarere.
Soup smearing his honey with honey.
Might we speak?
Yeah? What is it?
Now, why does one summon a witcher, hmm? To inquire about the gossip currently flowing about the court? I have a problem with a beast.
Ah, you the one posted the notice? Go on then, spit it out. What's it about?
First, my dear witcher, we must establish ground rules. Given the vast difference in our respective social positions, I'm sorry to say I take umbrage at the familiar tone you take. I expect deference. I expect you to address me as Sir, or better yet, as Monsieur de Bobo.
Listen, friend. There's an enormous difference between us, but it's not about status. It's about me having two swords on my back, and you having none. So I'll call you whatever I want, and you either deal with that or solve your monster problem yourself.
Call. I shall file a complaint with your guild.
Mm-hmm. Make sure you address it to customer service. Kaer Morhen, Kedwin. Now talk, before I change my mind and go.
Nautlings and their manners. Very well. Let us get this over with. Something has infested my vineyard.
Mm-hmm. Great. Let me go prepare my something oil then.
I beg your pardon?
Need more information than that. Where was this something seen? Any witnesses? Bodies to examine?
Therein lies the rub. None has seen the beast. We've only heard signs of its presence, a strange scratching and shrieks. Neither are there any corpses to inspect. Men simply disappear without a trace.
Noises you mentioned. Where do they come from?
Well, everywhere. But they're most clearly audible in the wine cellar.
Means the monster must dwell underground. When are the noises loudest?
In the night, just as they were years ago, when the buildings quaked. Another expert agreed to look into the matter then, but was never thereafter seen nor heard of.
Who's disappeared, if you don't mind my asking?
Most recently, some farmhand.
I believe. Despite the vast difference in social status, you remember the farmhand's name, maybe?
No. You must speak to my wife. She has more collegial relations with this household help. She's away at the moment visiting her mother, but should return forthwith. Oh, that should suffice with the questions. Now tell me, will you take the contract? Yea or nay?
Depends. What kind of reward are we talking about?
Come now, be reasonable. Fine. Seems I must take the loss. Agreed.
Fine, I'll do it. Need to look around here first. Then I'll want to talk to Madame de Bourbeau.
Very well. I shall inform you once she has returned. Meanwhile, the key to the cellar. Just, whatever you do, please do not disturb the wine barrels.
Be gone from my sight!
The monster actually is nocturnal. Gotta wait till dark. Look around. Rats. Not known to kidnap farmhands. What the hell? Shattered dishes. Off the shelf somehow. Shaken off, maybe? A tunnel? That's better.
Show me what you got.
Ah!
destroy them before the young hatch. Start prowling the vineyard. Cracked Kikimore eggs. Feeding on them. No Kikimore dug this. Tunnels are the work of something much bigger. Something with heavy, wide claws. Underground stream. Monster I'm looking for lives underground, digs tunnels, feeds on Kikimores. It is big, very big. Won't learn anything else here. Time to go back to the surface.
Sacre bleu!
What is the meaning of this? I'm paying you to slay a monster, not demolish my property!
Property's falling apart on its own, what with all the tunnels under it. I'd fill those in soon if you don't want your building to collapse.
Tunnels? Fiddle, my farm! How did tunnels appear down there?
Something dug them. A large creature. Also killed a few Kikimores down there and destroyed their eggs. Consider it a half favor. Won't cost you much.
Kikimore eggs? Yes, of course. Good work. Indeed, a reward is due.
Madame de Bourbeau, I presume? Hear you know something about the missing farmhand.
Jean-Luc? Yes. We went to examine this year's seedlings. Something had been nibbling at them. Then we heard these odd noises. Jean-Luc went to reconnoitre, and never returned.
Where'd you last see Jean-Luc, madame? Exactly.
In the fields, north of here, by the wood.
New seedlings there? I was under the distinct impression we had planted them all on the south slope.
Almost all, my dear. I requested that some be planted to the north, by the grove. Just the remainders.
Madame, could you describe Jean-Luc?
Tall, exceedingly well built, hair black as pitch.
Dear, concentrate. There is not a peasant that is not well built. They work in the fields all day. He means scars, birthmarks, that sort of thing.
Then none, I suppose. But he did wear a pendant around his neck. A silver one.
Silver jewelry on a farmhand?
It was a gift, I believe. Or that is what he claimed.
Should be enough to go on.
Then what are you fritting round here for? Get to work! Perhaps I can turn these tunnels into an extended cellar.
Be gone from my sight!
It was laid out here. Bread's really stale. Been here a while. Blanket was laid out here. Good vintage. Must have been a special occasion. Someone had a picnic. Or something. Trail ends here. Looks like she went back to the manor. Something walked through here. Big bastard with a heavy tail. Deep tracks. Felled trees, as if something rolled over them. So is Shalemar. Only they dig tunnels and move like that. Thank you. to that cave. silver pendant. A lock of hair inside. Same color as Madame de Bourbeau's. Dead end. I want to look around some.
That's it, Roach.
What's going on there? Why do you sneak up?
You. Can we talk?
You'd best be bearing good news. Get on with it.
This Jean-Luc, he did have a silver pendant. Kept a lock of Madame de Bourbeau's hair in it, matter of fact.
What? But how could she? To be unfaithful to me? A lord and heir with a plow-spawned peasant? Oh, she shall pay for this.
Don't doubt that. But mind paying me first? For services beyond the scope of the contract?
There. It'll come out of her dowry.
Got rid of the beast that was giving you trouble. It was a Shelmar.
Shelmar? Whatever could that be?
Kind of like a cross between a mole and a caterpillar. Just big as a barn.
Well, Master Witcher, you make a poor first impression, but ultimately proved your worth. There, your reward. Now, forgive me. I must speak to my wife.
Folks say some large armored hell tides beneath the foundations. It's why things are toppling.
A blind giant, this damned beast. Meandered all about.
Quite a bit of stone and brickwork awaits.
That it does.
Witcher or not?
Bust your bum.